Test, test, test. Okay, this is August 20th, 1973. The time is 3:47 p.m. Location is the Hewitt residence on Route 17. It's where victim one was found. We're going to do a walkthrough, and we're now descending the stairs into the furnace room. There's over here, there's scratch marks along the wall. There's some more over here. Along here, and oh, there's something over here. Seems, looks like a clot of hair and a embedded fingernail. All right, we're gonna go move into the actual furnace room.
Watch yourself. Look out.
Oh man. Oh. Look out. You got it? All right. This is the actual furnace room. Going into. Where are they expected to perpetrated? Got a bit of a jump there.
Got it? That's okay. Don't worry.
Come on back here. Follow me.
Texas is this hour's top news story. An informant led officers of the Muerto County Sheriff's Department to a cemetery just outside the small rural Texas community of Newt early this morning. Officers there discovered what appeared to be a grisly work of art, the remains of a badly decomposed body wired to a large monument. A second body was found in a ditch near the perimeter of the cemetery. Subsequent investigation has revealed at least a dozen empty crypts, and it's feared more will turn up as the probe continues. Deputies report that in some instances, only parts of a corpse had been removed. The head, or in some cases, the extremities removed, the remainder of the corpse left intact. Evidence indicates the robberies have occurred over a period of time. Sheriff Jesus Maldonado refused to give details in the Ghoulish case and said only that he did have strong evidence linking the crime to elements outside the state. Area residents have reportedly converged on the cemetery, fearing the remains of relatives have been removed. No suspects are in custody as the investigation at the scene continues.